All right, we're going a little bit picker. So let's run the project right now. And we'll go to the emulator. So here it is. I've got some people's names in there. My names, but if I quit the program and if I start it again, it won't remember the students' names. Oh, I guess it did. It didn't kill itself. All right. Anyways, so what we're going to deal with in this one is when we have edit students, we don't see our current students. So what we want to do is we want to produce a list of these students, right? So we do this by going into our resources, into layout, and let's go to our list students. So we got student picker, and you can see this is where we keep the list. So our list view is called a student list view. And this one is going to be on the student list students activity. Okay? So we've already done the add students part, where we can add the students, but our list view doesn't get filled with anything. So what we can do is when it's created, we can actually get our current student list and fill it. So why don't we do that? So what we'll do is we'll go, let's see, we'll get first our list view. List view equals find by ID, our ID. I don't remember that. So let's go back here and take a look at what its ID was again. Student list view. Yeah, student list view. All right. So back to here. Student list, and I'm going control space, and it code completes it for me. So I got a list view, and what's it saying? List view cannot be resolved to a type, so the solution is to import it. So up here, it added it. Okay, so, oh, still another problem. Add cast to list view, yeah. So now it does the right thing. Now it's just saying our list view isn't used. What we want to do is we want to fill our list view with items that we have. Our items will be from our student list. From our student list, we can get a collection of students. So what we want to do is we want to do something like add to the list view our data. So let's see. Add children, array list, children for accessibility, add focusables, add footers, add view. Okay, none of these are actually relevant. If you really want to know more about the list view, I recommend you go to Google or you go to, I like Vogela, I don't know how to pronounce it. This tutorial's pretty good by Lars Vogel. So if we search for, Android list view. So if we search for Android list view, we get this API guide for list views. And it says use a cursor, and we've got like a list view loader. It extends the list view activity, and it starts using a cursor. This cursor stuff is for SQLite, and if you're not going to use SQLite, it's not that important. What you should notice, though, is up here is that it says a list view is a view group that displays a list of scrollable items. The list items are automatically inserted to the list using an adapter. So the adapter is really what we care about. So I'll open up adapter. And what we can see is that the adapter is it's an interface, and it has subclasses like base adapter, cursor adapter, array adapter. And what we can do, well, we can read what it does. An adapter object acts as a bridge between an adapter view and the underlying data for that view. The adapter provides access to data items. The adapter is also responsible for making a view for each item in the data set. So what we're dealing with is we're dealing with a collection of things. So what we can do is when we know an interface is used, we can look in the Java doc and see subclasses And we can also look at the C also. So if we click on Array Adapter, what we find is it's a base adapter that is backed by an array of arbitrary objects. By default, this class expects the provider resource ID references to a single text view. So that really means that it's this one text view that's going to be the view of the item. And it says if you want to make a more complex layout, you should use a different thing. Now, let's look at the constructors. The first constructor is the context and the resource. This resource is this text view it's talking about. So it says it can take an array of objects. It can take an array of objects and a text view resource ID, and it can take a list of objects. Arrays are hard to change, so let's try to use a list. So let's try to use this array adapter thing such that we can take our student list and put it in. Okay, so list view add. So what we want is we want an array adapter, and it's going to be of students, and we're going to call it, student adapter equals new array. I go control space to code complete, and I want this one. The context will be this activity, so I'll just provide this. The resource will be like one of those RIDs. Okay. So one RID that we can use is we can actually use RIDs from Android. So we can go, I think we can go Android R and Android R ID, and we can go like this. There's something in here. It's not selected icon. There is a should be like a item input icon. All right, so I forget which one it is. I'm going to go back to this tutorial, and there's a simple item that we can use. Oh, so it's Android R, our layout, simple item. Okay, so we'll go back here. Android R layout. All right, now we're starting to get a list. I want simple item one. Now, this is pretty arbitrary, but what it is it's a layout that we can use, and we can use it to lay out the text views that are going to be created of the list that we put in. So we still need a list. All right, what's it complaining about here? Array adapter. So let's just make an array list. And it's complaining it doesn't know what array lists are. Let's see here. Array adapter T cannot be resolved to a type. Cannot be resolved to a type. Have we imported it? It is imported. Oh, the type. See, the T here has to be injected. So we have to provide student. Now it's just complaining about list. Local variable list may not have been initialized. No, we haven't initialized it. So what we can do is we can try this new array list, and we can actually initialize array lists with, we should be able to copy in other collections. So if we go collection student, we can go students equals new student list controller get student list. Student list get students. Doesn't know about collection. Okay, is this good now? What's it complaining about now? Static method from type should be accessed in a static way. Oh, am I doing this wrong? Okay. Student list controller. Maybe it's like get student list. Okay, that one's static. choose student. Okay, let me see what the controller has. All right, so it never really gives up its list. So we can actually just statically call that. So it says this is static, which means that we don't need an instance of the class to run it. So let's go back here. So we don't need a new student list controller. We can just ask the student list controller for the get student list. And then we can get students from that list. So we get a collection. Now what we can do is we can try to see if we can initialize this array list with it. What's it complaining about? Type safety. Okay, so you can see here that I've given it a generic for student, and ArrayList doesn't have that. So I can add it, and I add it to both sides, and the warning goes away. What's this warning? Okay. So now we've got something that works pretty well. We made a new array adapter. But what's this warning? This warning says the value of the local variable student adapter is not used. And then it says the value of local variable list view is not used. That's correct. We've just either created them or found them. So what we want to do is we want to add to the list view, we want to add an adapter. Okay, I don't see it there. So I got rid of add, and now we're just going to look for, maybe it's in set. There we go, set adapter. And we've already got student adapter, and we'll close that off. Okay, so now it should be listing our student list. So let's go run student picker again. And let's see, come on, run. This arm thing's pretty slow. Oh, there it is. Let's go to edit students. Nothing's there. Let's see what happens if I add Abram. Nothing. Okay. What if we go edit students again? Okay. So a student has showed up there, but I guess it's because of the two string. Because if we go back to the documentation, array adapter, we can see, however the text view is referenced, it will be filled with the two string of each object in the array. So this means that we want our students to actually do a good two string. So we got get name. So we want a public. Let's go string to string. And let's return get name. So we've got that. Maybe we should add a test. We could make a whole new test, or we could do this. Student name to string equals student get name. Student name to string is not equal. Save that. Let's run our student picker test. Make sure it works. Let's go to JUnit. Let's run it again because I don't know if it worked. Okay, so it's starting to compile and it's doing its thing. Installation failed or some test run. Okay. I'm not totally sure it worked, so because of that, I'm willing to do some code cloning and try the same thing with student to string. Okay, because I want to be sure that this works. I don't want to be surprised. So now it's uploading. It's going to run, and we should see two tests done in student test. Okay, student test. Okay, so they both passed. So, okay, that's good. So that means our two string works. And now let's go back to our list students activities and let's run our student picker again with our new two string. Let's go to edit students. I don't see any. Let's add Abram. It's not showing up. What if we go back to it? All right, So there's Abram. That's good. But if I add James, this isn't showing up. Do you know why this isn't showing up? Well, it's because we have to tell the adapter that its data has changed. And actually, we have to change the data because it's actually taking the data out. So this is where it gets sort of complicated. If I add students here, should I have to update everything else? This is pretty annoying, actually. So what maybe we should do... Well, we'll make a small compromise here. We know that we've added a student, so we know we have to update the student list. But it's not really going to work out. So the problem that we're going to try to address here is the student list. I think we should do this the right way. So when something is added to the student list, when we add a student, what we should do is we should do something like this. We should go notify all. And what notify all will do is it will tell anyone who's listening to us that we've changed. Okay? So that means I have to make notify all. So I'll just start here with not up here. We'll go to the end here. We'll go public notify all. Public void notify all. We just won't do anything in it. What's it complaining about? Cannot override the final method from object. All right, so it already exists in object. That's why it didn't complain. So let's go notify listeners. All right. So it's complaining about that. That's good. So let's create that method. Create method notify listeners. I'll get rid of this notify all, which we're not supposed to make. And we'll leave the to-do there because we're not finished it. Now, if we're adding new features, we should add tests for it. So this is a student list. Let's go to the student list test. What I want to do is I want to test notify listeners. And really what I want is I want code that looks something like this. Student list equals new student list. Okay, so I've got a new student list, and what I want to do is I want to student list add student, and we're going to add a new student. We're going to add a new student, but what I want is I want a listener to know about this. So basically I want a listener. And that listener is going to have a method called called update. And inside of update, what it's going to do is it's going to set updated to false. String weight to string value of parse to string. Get class notify all. All right, that's not going to work. Okay, so what we want to do is from update, we want to make sure that something was updated. Okay. So, and this listener we're going to add to student list, add listener L. Okay. And then what we want is we want this to tell us that we saw something. So let me just see. Integer I equal new integer I. We'll just go one. Reverse two. Okay. Long Android development. Wrapper for primitive type. Are these things immutable? Public methods. What's their superclass number? Do they have a set? Short int value. Okay, so they're not mutable. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to make just a value here that's called boolean updated equals false. And what we're going to do with this is we're going to go what was this thing called? It's called student list test. So let's go student list test this updated equals true. Okay. And then here we can go assert true. Student list didn't fire an update off. And we're going to go list.updated. Okay, fortunately we need to resolve this. So we have to create a class actually to deal with this. So let's create the class up here. Let's go new. It doesn't actually have to be a class though. What we can do is we can make an interface. Interface. It's a Java interface. And it's going to be called listener. And it's not going to extend anything. It's just going to be called listener. And it has a public method called public void update. Oh, it can't have code. Okay. Because it's an interface. So interfaces are used because they don't have code, but they say that if anything implements an interface or if anything is a class of an interface, you can call these methods on it. So what's happening down in here in student list test is I'm going to import CA software process student picker listener. I'm going to import that and I'm going to make a new anonymous class. So this is a class that isn't named, and all it's going to do is when it gets an update, it's just going to say, it's just going to operate this code. So it's going to use this here and operate the code. Okay, so create method, add listener in type student list. Yes. So we'll create this method in student list. Now we jumped projects again. Now we're back here in student picker and we've got add listener. We actually don't have to do anything yet, so that's nice. Okay. So student picker test. So what we're actually implementing is basically the observer pattern. The observer pattern allows you to have an observable that is observed, and then it tells any observers or like listeners that when it's changed, something that it has changed and that they can choose to update whether they update if they want to or not. Okay, add listener, add student, newbie, student listener didn't fire off. Okay, so let's try running this. And let's just make sure that updated equals false at the start. So let's run student picker test. yes, save the changes. There's errors. It's, it's updated. Student picker test. Let's go to JUnit. We're going to care about this test suite. It's running, launching, being slow. And there's one failure right here. Student list didn't fire off an update. Okay, so that means that our student list didn't call anything. Okay, so we've already got notify listeners. And we've got add listener. What we should do is we should make a list of listeners. So let's go array list listeners equals listeners. Oops, it's not going to be listeners, it's going to be listener. Array list of listeners. And when we make the student list, we're going to make a listener list. It's called listeners. Okay. And then what notify listeners will do, it'll go for for iterate over collection for each, here we go. For each listener in listeners. Okay, for each of the listeners in listener, call listener update. Okay. So now it can notify listeners. If we run the test again, they should still fail because we don't actually add listeners. So what we should do is we should go listeners, add L, get rid of this, and it still fails. Now I've added it, so let's test it again. Oh, it's just going to run student picker. I want it to run student picker test. All right, so it'll eventually run the test. It's launching, it's running the test. All right, all the tests pass. One other thing that we should add is we should do a remove listener. Test, remove listeners. All right, so we add the listener, and then I'm going to go student list, remove listener, and I'm going to give the same listener, and this should be false. So it's pretty well the same test, except I've removed the listener. All right, now it's giving me a compile error. It says we got to create that method, so I went and created the method. It should compile now. Let's run the student picker test. It should fail. Now you're wondering, why are you doing this again? You know it's going to fail. Well, if it doesn't fail, then my test doesn't work, right? So I should at least have confidence in my test by trying out the test first. All right, now it says it doesn't work. Good. So now we should go add remove listener. Let's see. Open declaration. See, isn't that cool? I pressed F2 and then I clicked open declaration. To remove a listener, I should just go listeners, remove listener. Pretty cool. That should work. Let's try the student picker test again. Installing it, doing the thing, running the unit test, taking forever. And what we find is, yes, all tests have indeed passed. So this thing can add and remove listeners. So that's pretty cool. Let's go back to list student activities. And what should happen is that we should basically tell, basically when our student list changes, we should update this. So the idea is we add a listener. So I can add a listener right here. I can go, where is it? Student list controller, get student list, add listener, new listener, and it's put in the code for me, right? And so what I can do right here is on an update, I can say, I'll take that list of students and I'll clear it, and then I'll add all, and I got to get a collection, so I need a collection of students, so I need need something like this. So I'll get a collection of students and I'll add them all back. Now, this is inefficient. You're going to say, hey, Abram, this is really gross. Why'd you do that? Well, because it's easy and performance doesn't matter right now. When performance matters, we can go deal with this. But I don't have a test for performance right now, and I'm not going to write a test. So frankly, I don't care about it that much at the moment. More so care about getting this to work. Now, it's complaining that I can't reference list. Basically, the reason I can't reference list is because I've made a new class here and it needs a reference to this one. But once this method finishes, because it will finish, the second it hits here, it returns. Once this method finishes, all these local variables will mostly disappear. And so if I have to tell Java that I want to share this variable, and I'm not going to change it after the initial assignment. I want to share it with it here, right? So what I'll do is I will make it final. By making it final, it means I am not going to change this after initial assignment, which means I'm not going to reassign to it. The data in here can change, but it will always point to this array list. So that means when I make something here, it'll refer to that list. So that means we're going to add a change listener here, and it will update the students when the student list changes. Okay, so let's see if that works. We'll go run student picker. And we'll go over. Okay, choose a student, no students. Let's go edit students. Let's add Abram. Okay, I don't see Abram. Wait. Why did that work? Watched it. What about James? Okay, I don't see it. So if we go back, and so why didn't James get updated? Well, the reason why James didn't get updated is because we haven't told the user interface to actually do any updates. The way we can tell the user interface to do an update is we can tell the student adapter, right? We can tell it that, we can notify it that the data set that it used has changed. So we can do that. Although it says we need to change the modifier to final. Why is that again? Well, because once this method exits, the student adapter still has to exist and be referenced by this listener. So we'll make it final. So change that to final. Got that. Let's try this now. Okay, student picker. And we'll go back to Android. Okay. Are there any students in here? No, there's no students. Let's go edit students. I don't see any students. Let's add Abram. Abram shows up. Let's add James. James shows up. Let's add Hindle. Hindle shows up. So we got three students. Come over here. Choose a student. Yeah, all three show up. So that's pretty cool. We've now got a list view that works. Nothing really fancy. Notice when we add students here, we didn't have to do a bunch of work. We didn't have to do specifically this work, right? So this work is already being done for us, and it's being done because we're being told that the student list changed. And this is because we're using an observer pattern, which is really handy pattern. All right, so we've added an observer here. Okay, so whenever the student list changes, we will update that list. One thing we should do is we should actually remove the listener when we clean up this activity, but I'm not going to get into that right now. Now, we're still missing one thing. So if I go over here to LibreOffice, go F5, right? Do you see this? We want to click on students, right? We want a long click, and then we want to delete a student. So let's add that. Okay, so what we want is that list view. We want to add, for that list view, we want to add a list view set long, no, there should be like a add before bring children. There should be like a add listener or something like that. Like set a listener, something along those lines. On the list view, let's see. Oh, on key HJJK. On track perform, maybe there's like a set clip, set duplicate, set focusable, set layout. On create, so what we'll do is we'll click on the list view. We'll look at the list view guide. We'll look at the list view documentation. So it's a adapter view. So what about click? Add view, get position. Remove all views, initialize. So here we go, set on click, set on item, set item long click. Okay, so let's go back and let's go set, let's try the set on click, on click listener, on item long click. Register a callback to be invoked when an item in this adapter view has been clicked and held. Sounds about right. And the listener, so we need a new kind of listener for this. So an adapter view on click on item click listener. That sounds about right. Okay, it's complaining. Okay, so let's go create the class. No, we want to import it. Add unimplemented methods. So the quick fix is we must implement this abstract method. An abstract method is a method that we have to implement in order to implement an instance or implement a class or an instance of that class. So using Eclipse, it filled this in for us. One thing we should know is that this on item long click, right? So if we go here, go F2, it gives a class overview. Open Java Doc and browser. on item click. So it goes int position and long ID. So what we really care about is that position. So we'll call this position, and we'll just call this one ID. This is the view, and then this is the adapter view. Okay. So when this list view is long clicked, what we want to do is we want to get that item, and we want to delete it. So I'll just show you how it works right now. Let's see, where is it? I'm going to put in a toast, and the toast is going to, what the toast is going to do is it's going to get the student list controller, get student list, get, get students, get, this is a lot of dots. This is a bad smell, by the way. We'll get position. Oh. So we wanted that original list. Okay, do we have access to it? Yes, we already have the list. So we can just use that list, and we can go get position. And then we'll go to string, and we'll just say delete plus that, okay? And I'll get rid of adding a student and get rid of that and make text. Toast is not applicable. Oh, okay. So what it's complaining about here is the context. An adapter view is not a context. The context that exists is actually the list student's activity is the context we want. So let's get that. So we get that this. It sounds a little confusing. All right, let's try this out. So we go back to edit students. Is there anything in here? I'll add that one. If I long click, it says delete Abra. It doesn't delete it because I didn't do anything. So what we should do is we should remove that student. So what we should probably do is get the student list. So first we want to get the student, and we go list get position. So we get that student. Positon. Gotta spell it right. So we get that student. And then we want to get the student list, and we're going to remove that student from that student list. Okay? So we'll save. We'll try that out. Open this up. Edit students. We'll add a student. New student. Add. I'll long click it. It's not gone. Weird. So now let's go edit students. There's no student there. So it is deleted, but it didn't disappear when we saw it. Now, the reason why it didn't disappear is because, well, we didn't tell anyone that it disappeared. Remove student doesn't actually send any kind of events. So let's go back to our test, student list test. And let's try let's set updated to false again. Let's add to this test notify listeners. Set update to false. And let's remove that student from the list. Student list, remove student. And the student we, okay, so we should move this to student test student equals and we go test student. All right. So now we should remove it from the list, and this should be true. Okay. Oh, I guess I should do that. So I save. Everything looks okay. I'm going to go run the student picker test again. This time it's got remove students. Maybe we should say removing a student from the student list didn't fire one off. But it failed nonetheless. So it failed right here. Because remove student didn't fire off an update. So, because we set updated to false and... Okay, so let's make remove student actually do an update. Oop. So let's see, remove student. So all we need to do is to say we've mutated the list, let's notify the listeners. Okay, so save and run the student picker test again. Now we wait, because I'm using the ARM one. And everything works. Excellent. So this means that when I run student pick... Oh, wait, no, that's just going to run the test again. Run student picker. When I run student picker, I should be able to delete people from it immediately. Let's run that again, student picker. At least our test passed. They only take a second to run. All right, so let's go edit students. We'll add Abram. And we'll add Abram too. We'll delete Abram. And he's deleted. Okay, so that's pretty cool. That worked out really well. Except, if we go and check LibreOffice, check this out. This is 11. What we wanted is when you long click, you don't automatically delete a student. It gives you a dialog that allows you to delete a student. Okay? So we want to basically make a dialog. So if you want to do something new in Android, you should really Google it, to be honest. So like, I've got alert dialogs here, but what I would have done is I would have gone Android dialog, and then you would have come out with dialogues and dialog, and you would have seen in dialogues that they mention that they have that you shouldn't use dialog directly, that they have an alert dialog, and then if we click on alert dialog, we see it's a little complicated, but an alert dialog has a bunch of setters. It's got a set message. That's good. And let's just see. Alert dialog. Who's its superclass? Dialog. What does dialog have? Dialog has things like... has a lot of methods, but it has... let's see. Set owner, set dismiss message. That's good. I think there's like a positive one kicking around here. So it's got this idea of positive and negative. Who's its dialog interface? So dialog implements dialog interface, and dialog interface provides cancel and dismiss. It also provides click listeners, dismiss listeners, things like that. Known indirect subclasses. Okay. One neat thing is you can actually use this thing called a builder. The builder lets you build a dialog. So it allows you to set messages, allows you to set multiple choices, lets you set negative buttons, lets you set positive buttons. So builder is a kind of pattern. It's sort of like a factory. It allows you to build a complicated class, and they'll set everything up for you. So we're going to build something using this. So the constructors are the context. All right, so let's make a dialogue. So we'll go back to Eclipse, And on delete, instead of toasting, what we're going to do, that's, okay. So I like the functionality as is. I don't want to comment things out. And I've also got tests and I've added new functionality. So what I should just do is I should commit it. So we go student picker test. We're going to go git status. We got two modified test files and I'm just going to commit them and it's going to say added observer tests. So I've committed those and I'll just push them for good measure. And then I'll go back to my student picker repo and I'll git status this. Oh, see, I got a new file, so I'll go git add that. And then I'll go git commit dash av. And I'll see that I've got a new file and I modified three other files. So we've added lists, we've added imports. We had a whole bunch of code to deal with setting items and seeing items. We added listeners to student list and the observer stuff. So added observer pattern to student list, added delete, added delete student and update student to the list students activity. Okay, so those are the things I did. Application now shows active student list and it updates appropriately. Okay, so I've got that. I'm going to push it. Okay, now the reason I did a commit there is because I don't want to comment this out. I'm going to use the fact that I could come back anytime to that commit to basically just delete this. I don't need this. What I want at this point is I want an alert dialog builder. And we'll go ADB equals new alert dialog builder context. And the context will be this. Oh, this isn't going to work. It's, yeah, so it's saying that this doesn't, this, what this refers to is actually this class and not this class. So to make it refer to the proper context, I'd say, well, no, I mean the list students activity this. So now I've got a proper context. So now I can go set message, and the message can be delete. Oh, I guess I should have done that. And then, so the plus is overloaded and allows us to do string concatenation. So I'm going to set the message to that, and I'm going to go set positive button, and I'm going to set the text of that button to be delete, and there's going to be an onClick listener. We'll deal with that in a sec, and then we're going to have a negative button, and it's going to be cancel. There's going to be a listener, and then we're going to go ADB set cancelable true because it is cancelable. Okay, and now we got to make this listener. What is this listener? Change to list, parameter listener, create parameter listener, create constant field. This thing takes in a onClick listener. So let's go new onClick listener. So we're making yet another anonymous class. And okay, so set positive button. So we're going to import that. So that went away. And now what's the complaint again? Add unimplemented methods. So we add the unimplemented methods. No, please add them. Okay, so it added our onClick for us. Let's deal with this onClick. Basically, this is the positive case. So we actually want to delete the student. So we move our deletion code in there, and we discover that position is unavailable. And why is it unavailable? In position, no, give me the help. Okay, what's the help text here? Cannot refer to a non-final variable position inside the inner class. All right, it says we can't refer to it. So I'll call it final position, and I'll assign position to it. And we'll go final position. Okay. Oh, what's this say? Syntax error. Because we didn't give it a type. Okay. So this one needs a new click listener, so we're not actually going to do anything. So let's give it one of these, and we'll do nothing. Okay. So let's try this out. We've now got something that will ask us if we want to delete a student or not. So let's go to edit students. Let's add a student, a.student, add that student. Let's long click on them. Long click. All right, it doesn't work. I bet it is working. What about this? Oh, so this will be list student activity, same error. Let's try this again. Edit the students. We'll add a.student. We'll long click on them. So it is working. So let's open the context and open the Java doc. Okay, let's open the context. And let's just go to Java doc for a dialog alert builder. Set cancelable, Oh. Creates an alert dialog with the arguments supplied to the builder and shows the dialog. Okay, so obviously what we got to do is we got to do this. adb.show. Just comment that out. So now we're going to show it. So let's play it. Okay. Back here, edit students, a.student, the creator of the t-test, delete a student, cancel, delete a student, delete. Okay, let's go add, delete a student, delete, delete a student, delete. Delete a student, delete. Okay, so I'm relatively happy with that. It seems to work, although I've got duplicate students, so maybe I should just delete the duplicate student. Let's just add B. Let's go C, D, E. All right, and we'll click back. So we've got lots of students. Edit the students. Let's edit the middle student. Let's get rid of the first student and the last student. And let's go back. All right. So we've got a working list view, and we updated our model such that it can update anyone who cares about it. So if we go back to edit students, we still have the students. And we also get to see a list of the students. Let's just try one more thing. So I'm going to quit it. We're going to run it again. All right, so it still maintains persistence. So what I want you to know is if we go here, then we go here, and we see student picker still running, right? So I just killed it. I dragged it off and killed it in Android. Now if we start it again, oh, it's still persistent. So it's not totally killed. Okay, but if I restart this ADB, it's not going to remember those things. So the next thing we're going to work on is the fact that student list is never saved anywhere. So the next video is going to be on improving student lists. Just to review this video, we added a pattern called the observer pattern where it allows us to notify listeners that we've changed. And we don't really tell them anything. We just say update. And this means that if someone cares if we update, they can deal with our change. For instance, we use the array adapter and we say, hey, array adapter, your list has changed. We update the list and we get the array adapter to update. Okay? We also went over list views and how we can give data to a list view. And we did it in this sort of hacked up way using an array adapter. You can make your own adapters and you can extend the array adapter such that you don't have to do this sort of hinky list setup here. All right. So I hope this was helpful.